If you search the living world for the epitome of natural grace, power, intelligence, and design, your journey could well lead to a pod of dolphins. There are at least 36 different species of these extraordinary mammals, and they inhabit every ocean in the world. Dolphins can swim at speeds up to 18 miles per hour and leap more than 20 feet into the air. Their bodies are sleek and streamlined, the ideal shape for cutting effortlessly through the water. A quality ensured by glassy, smooth outer skin that shed and completely regenerated several times a day. And they can hold their breath up to 10 minutes while plunging to depths of more than 1,000 feet. But of all the dolphin's magnificent attributes, one gift rises above the rest. Their uncanny use of sound to thrive in an often dark and murky world. Captain Dave Anderson has devoted thousands of hours to the study of dolphins off the coast of Dana Point in Southern California. Much of his research has focused on echolocation and the animal's use of reflected audio waves to hunt and navigate. A key tool in this work is a hydrophone, a device designed to monitor and record sound underwater.
I mean, we can hear that pod from miles away. And as the dolphins approach the hydrophone, the sounds get unbelievably loud. The clicks all sound like a Geiger counter. And then you'll hear, it almost sounds like a radio trying to tune in with all the whistles and the clicks going on. And the whistles are how the animals talk to one another. And so these dolphins are communicating through their whistles, and then they've got the clicks. And the clicks are how they're finding their prey.
These distinctive clicks are critical to survival. For in a dolphin's world of often limited visibility, immediate recognition of potential food sources, allies, or enemies hinges upon sensory mechanisms other than vision.
You can't see very far underwater, but sound travels four times faster underwater than it does on land. So they're able to use sound to see.
In basic terms, echolocation works like this. The animal produces a series of low and high frequency sounds that are transmitted through its forehead. After these sonic waves hit an object, echoes bounce back. The greater the distance, the longer the delay in their return. When the dolphin receives the reflected signals, it forms a mental image of the target's location, size, and speed.
When they're chasing a fish, they'll go into a huge school of fish and they'll zero in on one fish. And they'll follow that single fish until they catch it. And if that fish jumps out of the water, they're right there jumping out of the water with it.
To function correctly, echolocation requires many component parts, each designed for a specific purpose. When integrated, they form the most efficient sonar system on Earth, natural or man-made. After rising to the surface, the dolphin exhales, takes a quick breath, and then tightly seals its blowhole. Inside of its head, the inhaled air rushes through twin nasal passages on its way toward two sets of flaps called the phonic lips. When the air makes contact, the mechanism vibrates rapidly, like the lips of a trumpet player. These vibrations are reflected off of tissues and bones in the skull, then pass through the melon, an organ that fills most of the dolphin's forehead. The melon is highly flexible, and its shape is adjusted to fine-tune the transmission of sound through salt water. It works like an acoustical lens, focusing audio waves into cone-shaped beams.
If something is far away, they focus their sound and make it more of a low frequency sound because low frequency sounds travel further. And when something is nearby, they use a higher frequency sound, and that gives them more detail.
The melon concentrates the acoustical energy, and when the beam hits a fish, it reflects and bounces back. The returning echoes are channeled through the dolphin's teeth and lower jaw that function as antennae. This energy is amplified as it travels through large masses of tissue in and around the jawbone, and then on to sensitive mechanisms in the middle and inner ears. From the inner ear, signals are then transmitted through the auditory nerves to the brain, where they are analyzed in milliseconds. The dolphin interprets this data to produce a three-dimensional image of its target, complete with detailed information about its speed, texture, and shape. How well does echolocation work? In control tests, a dolphin can determine the difference between a golf ball and a ping pong ball based solely on the density of each object. And on the seafloor, it can find small fish buried 3 to 6 inches in the sand.
A dolphin can find a BB at the bottom of a swimming pool blindfolded. It can see inside of things. It's an amazing device. And if somebody had invented this and had it working as well as the dolphins, they'd make billions of dollars.
For this complex system to work, two more vital factors are crucial. Each of these finely tuned modules must be properly assembled and fully operational simultaneously. And second, the dolphin must immediately know how to operate the entire mechanism correctly.
So you've got all these different components for the sonar, and how does the dolphin know how to use this equipment? That's where instinct comes in. They not only got the hardware, but they got the owner's manual along with it. Instinct is a set of instructions on how to use the equipment, and it has to know that from the second it's born. All of this stuff happens automatically, and it's perfectly set up. It's like you look at it and you say, of course, that's the way it's supposed to work. So it's pretty hard to believe that this all happened by chance and natural selection, especially when each individual part is meaningless without the whole. It's just beautiful, breathtaking, and when you see it, you never forget it.